In this video, we're going to see how to write electron configurations just by looking at the periodic table. We're going to be able to read electron configurations from the periodic table. So in order to do that, we have to know about blocks. So this is a breakdown of the periodic table, and we have the S block, the P block, the D block, and the F block. So the first two columns in the periodic table are the S block. Every element that is in the first column of the S block, its electron configuration ends in S1. Hydrogen is 1S1, lithium is 2S, ends in 2S1, sodium ends in 3S1, potassium in 4S1, and so on. Every element that's in the second column ends in S2. Helium ends in, well, is 1S2. Beryllium ends in 2S2. Magnesium ends in 3S2. Calcium in 4S2, strontium in 5S2, and so on, right? Everything in the P block has its electron configuration ending in P something. If it's in the first column, it ends in P1, second column P2, P3, P4, P5, and everything in the sixth column in the P block, if that's that element, its electron configuration ends in P6. So neon ends in 2P6, argon 3P6, krypton 4P6, and so on. P5 for this column, these are the halogens here, P4, P3, P2, and P1. Now, when we're reading the periodic table, we read it left to right, top to bottom. When we finish a row, we go back down to the beginning of the next row. And what this is this is the same order that you saw in the last video with the energy levels. So it was 1s, so these two are 1s, and then we saw 2s right here. Then we saw 2p come next. After 2p was 3s, and then after 3s we saw 3p. And after 3p, we came down to 4s, and only after we filled the 4s could we put 3d. Now this is the D block. And notice that for the S block and the P block, the row, the period number is the same as the sublevel, 2, 3, 4, and so on. With the D block, the sublevel is one less. This 3D is in the fourth row, 4D is in the fifth row, and so on. Now remember, the F block really fits in right here between 6S, 5D, 7S, and 6D. And it really goes in here. So after the 6S, we come down to the 4F. After the 7S, we come down to the 5F. And the F block is 2 less than the row number. So if this is the 6th row, 6 minus 2 is 4. We're in the 4F. 7th row, we're in the 5F. So all you have to do to look at the periodic table and read an electron configuration for an element is read through the periodic table, filling in the last column in each block. So let's say we're down here. We're in the third column, in the third row of the P, and we're in the P block. So we're past the S block, so we'd say 1S2, because that's helium, that's the last one. And then the next one would be 2S2. And then we're past the 2P block, so it would be 2P6, that's this one right here. And then we come back here, be 3S2, because we're past the 3S block. And then we're in the 3P block, so it would be 3P3. So it would look like this. That gets us through helium. 2S2 gets us through here, which is beryllium. And then 2P6 gets us to the end of the P block over here. Coming back, we pass the 3S block, so we say 3S2. Remember, everything in this column is S2. And then we get to the block that we're in. We're in the third column over in the 3P block, so we'd say 3P3. And it ends up that that's phosphorus. Now, we can write the core notation, noble gas notation, for this really easily. All we have to go is to the previous noble gas. So as we're reading this periodic table from left to right, top to bottom, if this is phosphorus right here, the previous noble gas would be here, which is neon. So we could say also neon square brackets. And then we just have to do everything after neon, which would be 3s2, 3p3. See how to do that? So let's do a couple more. So here's a regular periodic table. And let's say we were writing the electron configuration for sodium. Well, there's sodium right here. So we would go through the blocks, 1s2. Then on this one, helium's over here, but really it's, we can go here. So 1s2, because we're past this there. Then we're past the 2s block, so 2s2. And then we're past the 2p block, so 2p6. And then we're in the first column of the 3s block, so we say 3s1. Or we could just write noble gas configuration. The previous noble gas, so for sodium, the last noble gas we went through was neon. So neon, and then just read this 3s1. All right, so let's say we wanted to do vanadium. So same thing. We would go, okay, first the long way. We're past the 1s block, so we go 1s2. We're past the 2s block, so we'd say 2s2. We're past the 2p block, so we'd say 2p6. Then we're past the 3s block, so we'd say 3s2. All right, so we're here. Then we're past the 3p block, argon, so we'd say 3p6. And then we're past the 4s block. We're past calcium because we're right here, right? So we'd say 4s2. And then we are in the 1, 2, 3rd column of the 3d block. So we'd say 3d3. Or using core notation, the previous noble gas was argon right here. So we'd say argon. And then just everything that comes after that up to our vanadium. So it'd be 4s2, then 3d3. Easy as that. So just remember, read the ends of each of the blocks all the way through, left to right, top to bottom, until you get to the block that you're in, and then just count over how many columns. And then just write the electron configuration. Now, there are two exceptions that I'm going to ask you guys to memorize, and just memorize these, all right? And these are chromium and copper. So chromium, if you just follow the order of filling like we just did, we would say argon 4s2 3d4, right? But it's not. It just memorizes. And chromium is an exception. Memorize it. It's argon 4s1 3d5. And copper, likewise. Okay, instead of being 4s2 3d9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's argon 4s1, 3d10. And basically the reason for these is it's just more stable. It's easier for them to be like this than the other way. So, but pretty much just memorize these. So at this point, you should be able to read off of the periodic table the electron configuration of the ground state of any neutral atom.